Hey YouTube. Just back to the normal videos after I got a big hitting baby metal guitar video last week. We're getting hundreds of hits. Woo. So this, sometimes guitars just kind of fall on you. This one, it's a Eastwood Monolith. It's like, yes. I swapped this for a guitar. The guy offered me, it's like, oh, a Tele. I don't know if I really want a Tele. I'd never really heard of Eastwood. And then he said it's got the biggest pickup on the planet. So I was like, it's quite big. I mean, let's be honest, that's a big pickup. I'm pretty sure I've seen bigger ones than that. I'm like, I think maybe an EBO neck pickup's maybe bigger than that. But so I looked it up and online and I saw it was called the Monolith, and suddenly it just became, maybe I do want the Monolith actually. Yep, so it's an Eastwood, I can't remember. I think there might only be 48 of these made, or that might have just been for the NAMM show or something. I've seen an advert for one of these that says there's only 48 made. This one should have a white scratch plate. That one's been spray painted black, matte black, which I might be changing. There's a chrome one in the original like NAMM show YouTube video. Also, the headstock on this one's been sanded, so it should have a black headstock. It looks alright actually in the video there, but in real life it's a bit patchy. And they've left they've just not sanded around a bit where the logo was. So it's got a maple neck, a maple fingerboards, don't know what the rest of it is, but it's painted black. And to me that looks like a through neck. It could be a glued in one, but normally a glued in one isn't as, you know, there's not enough there. So it'd have to be I don't know. But the only spec I could find for this guitar said it had a bound fretboard and a set neck, and it doesn't have a bound fretboard. So is the set neck thing right? Don't know. Yeah, so it's pretty cool. It's got this pickup in it, which is, it's what it says, it's signed by, it's got Kent Armstrong written in the back. And I think it might be a P90 and a single coil sort of humbucker type thing. Both the coils have the same ohms rating. They're both, I can't remember, was it 10.32 or something like that, but they're both exactly the same. So they might be two coils the same. Who knows? It's all sealed, it's all, you know, sealed in wax and plastic coated, so you can't actually get in at it. It's just got the four terminals coming out, the four terminals and earth. In fact, it's got two earths. Of course it does, because that would mean you could, sorry. So I got this. It was wired to do something and the tone control was disconnected. So I think the wiring, I've now worked out what it is it actually does, and I think it kind of, I think it's original. Well, it's not, it's someone's obviously done it themselves, but they've wired it the correct way. So this pickup, single pickup, has three sounds. I believe it was called pile driver, which is humbucker, cement mixer, which is the two coils in parallel and with an added cap, you know, like a tone cap with a different value on it. And then that one is, it's ice pick, it's called, which is meant to be like a P90 sound. So it might be, I think that might be a P90 and that might be a single coil. So in ice pick mode, you've got a P90 in the bridge. In the middle, you've got the two of them in parallel with a cap on it, which I might be taking off, to be honest. And then that one, you've got them both in series as a humbucker. So, humbucker first, I suppose. I'm intentionally standing in front of the map now so it doesn't distort the camera. And then cement mixer. So obviously it affects a different frequency from the tone control. Mind you, in saying that, the tone control was one I had lying on top of that amp, so I can't even remember where it's from. But it's quite a heavy metal machine. This was built as a sort of, I think, according to the bump I've read online, it appears to have been some American company made these pickups, and this was the guitar was made as a vehicle just for this pickup, and it's quite a heavy metal-y type. I love it, it's perfect for me. I mean, I like having a telly for that, but I just wouldn't have thought normal people would want an Esquire. Well, I keep calling that a telly, it's very difficult to think of it as an Esquire. I need to, I think I'm going to replace that scratch plate. I've actually got a one that was meant for another project, but it's like a black link, and it's shiny. I think it might look a bit better. I'm not really sure. Try not standing in front of the amp, see if it distorts the camera. I'm going to raise the pickup up a bit. I've already raised it up. It's the screws aren't quite long enough, and it was sitting much lower than that when I got it. I don't know what it would have been originally, but I just feel it's still quite a distance away from the strings. I quite like the way, because it's got the four screws, you can angle it to follow the strings. I like that. Yeah, so I actually had to do quite a bit of work to this to make it play. It was playing alright when I got it. The guy I swapped with, not really a guitar butcher like me. So it was playing fine, it just had a wee bit of a high action, but not hugely. I just thought that looking at it, it should be an awful lot better than it was. And then, so I got all set up, and quite a few of the frets, like about four of them, all over the place were just high. So it's out with the file and stuff, and I've brought them down, so now it's all playing all the way. And it's so these are the ones that were, these are the easy ones that weren't working. It's quite unusual having a maple fretboard on a painted neck. It kind of looks funny. Kind of reminds me of a Palin Sterling's SG. He had an SG with a maple neck, maple fretboard. It was the same sort of thing, similar sort of vibe. I wonder if this would have been better if they'd made it more popular, if they'd made it an SG. Thing is, it does get you three good sounds, usable sounds out of the single pickup. But it's like, if you just had two pickups, then it'd probably be cheaper, and you would get more than the three useful sounds. So it's kind of like sort of pointless a bit. Although it is cool. I'd probably rather that the middle one with the cap on it sounds like a neck pickup. We'll be right back. can't remember. I think this is just a keeper again. It's another one of these, one of my tailies. I just like tailies. It's still not quite gone full Esquire though. I still like the idea of how manly you'd have to be able to play like one single coil pickup and volume of tone. That's it, you know, rather than this has got just three sounds like the way I get any guitar would. I'm actually getting to grow the one in the middle's growing on me a wee bit with that tone cap on it. The output's down a wee bit, obviously, because it's the tone cap's sucking away some of the frequencies, so there's not as much signal. So I think I reckon if you turn the volume down, the other ones, it doesn't have to be that. That's the it's got that great thing that great pickups have, or great guitars have, where you've got like sort of 9 in the tone control. You've got it doesn't necessarily get very much louder, it just goes more bleh. That might be the soft tech doing that though.